enlightened management is not about getting work done from others. The manager is helping the person below in his or her evolutionary journey. And that is why a true leader is one who is helping the others below him or her evolve in their journey. This brings us to the concept of servant leadership. It is much like the parents who bring up the child and see the child making mistakes. However, they know that a person learning to walk will fall many times before mastering the art of walking. So when we develop this concept of servant leadership, our goal towards our subordinates or colleagues or bosses also changes. We are always trying to help out. This is an enlightened way of looking at the managerial work. A different perspective is any which way get what you can. But such models and companies utilizing such models don't last for too long. A better way of looking at it is the organization is fulfilling certain needs in society. And the people are paying the organization for the needs that are being fulfilled. So if you want more, you fulfill more needs. Similarly, the most successful in industry, one of them, Andrew Carnegie, who was one of the creators of corporate America as we know it, he explained his perspective. No person can succeed without helping those below succeed in their goals and objectives. So it is always by helping the others that you succeed. And if you see the charismatic leaders like Mahatma Gandhi, etc., Abraham Lincoln, what was so special about them? The special thing was they were always trying to help. And that is why their personality itself was inspiring. If you met Mahatma Gandhi for 2 minutes, he would inject something in you that would bring you a different perspective, that would help you change. And that is what created the charisma in this historical personality. So what was the secret of that charisma? Their attitude of servant leadership. Their desire to serve. This is what comes about from the spiritual perspective. Once I happened to see the Chanakya episode. You see, I was in somebody's house on Sunday. There was an episode coming on TV. It was the Chanakya serial that was running many couple of decades ago. So one dialogue got embedded in my mind. Chandragupta, Chanakya's disciple, illustrious king, he asked Chanakya Pandit, from your Vedic perspective, what is the position of the king apropos the subjects, the citizens of the state? Chanakya responded by saying, Raja praja ka das hai aur das ke atirikt aur kuch bhi nahi. This was a spiritual way of looking at managerial work, leadership work, or anything else. And when you do that, you will find your subordinates responding. A company can create cosmetic motivational methods to tell the employees, we care for you. But the employees are not foolish. They look through it all and they realize that if the company profits are at stake, they will not hesitate in dismissing us. But that boss who truly cares for the employees The employees immediately realize the difference and respond far greatly, become far more motivated. So that is why the spiritual paradigm of management says that your consciousness is as important to your managerial work as the theories and techniques that you learn in an institute like this.